Hello, Beauty with a Purpose team. Welcome to Haiti.
The Beauty with a Purpose program is here to help Haiti.
Welcome to Haiti.
Julia Morley is the chairman and CEO of Miss World Limited and the founder of Beauty with a Purpose. And she's joined by Wen Xia Yu, the reigning Miss World, Francisco Escobar, the reigning Mr. World, and by Claudine Book, the USA contestant for Miss World. With the help of their Miss World national organizations, the Miss World contestants have set up Beauty with a Purpose projects in more than 100 countries. This gives tens of thousands of young women every year the opportunity to use their abilities and to make a real and lasting contribution in the lives of the sick and disadvantaged. The poverty and suffering in Haiti is greater than at any time. It is hoped that this extensive visit will bring additional world focus on the desperate health and nutrition needs of the nation.
It's a disgrace.
Yeah.
Against humanity that we can all accept this.
Miss World CEO Julia Morley and the reigning Miss World Wen Xia Yu from China are leading a special team to Haiti to see firsthand the relief efforts and to take the $500,000 donated so far by the Miss World contestants as part of Beauty with a Purpose to the missions in Haiti.
This is the clinic in Pestel. It's the only clinic between here and Djibouti. It's the only real hospital that the people have that serves probably 70,000 people. There's one Haitian physician, Dr. Senek, who we'll be meeting. You'll see from the conditions of this hospital, it's incredibly run down. Unfortunately, he doesn't have the supplies, he doesn't have the materials that he needs to do this. When he has medications, he's able to treat patients. If he doesn't have them, he tries to make the best he can. This is a cholera tent. Cholera is a very violent diarrheal illness. People in Haiti die even within 6 hours of being diagnosed or starting to get the symptoms. It was a really, really powerful disease in Haiti. Well, I'm pleased to introduce you to Dr. Senek Philippe. Dr. Senek is the physician for this whole region.
This is Ms. World from China,
Francisco
from Colombia, from the United States, and of course Variety International, very important.
So I thought what might be helpful for the group here is to hear in your words about some of the health problems in Pestel related particularly to children.
Merci, Dr. Ben.
Thank you, Dr. Ben, and I'm very glad and happy to meet all these beautiful people today. This health center is taking care of multiple things like giving birth and
general
consultations,
vaccination,
nutrition.
And
recently we started with a HIV program.
HIV program, cholera, tuberculosis.
Through many different organizations, including Dr. Ben's and Variety International, collectively with Beauty with a Purpose, we will aim to find solutions with you. But we need to appeal to ordinary human beings like you and me and others to give a little each, and if we can get enough of those people, we can do things together.
Merci.
Thank you very much.
Doctor, I would like to say thank you very much for all the things you have done so far. Muchas gracias por todo lo que has hecho.
Thank you so much. Tell us about the hair. Thank you.
This means a lot for us, and we want to work on it to try to change it.
Both Wen Xia, Miss World, and Francisco, Mr. World, they are both working really hard on projects to help us. And everything Miss World does in her year is, when she wears the crown, it's a symbol for fundraising. So all the funds she is going to raise are with Beauty with a Purpose, and that's the whole point of the crown.
I think providing equipment for this clinic would do Dr. Senek a world of good. Not only the patients, he deserves it. This is a guy who has served his community for years and years.
Yes.
He's working under austere, terrible conditions, and the only reason, if you ask him, the reason that he's here is he loves the people. He grew up here, he's from here, and he continues to give back.
If this fresh water program starts, you wouldn't have to see these tents.
That's exactly it.
And that's the key. It's fresh water,
yeah,
and it's community, helping community.
There are still huge needs here. The problems of malnutrition, which underlies so much cause of child death, the problems of diarrhea, which is the number two cause of child death, are solvable problems. We just need more resources to be able to fix these things.
And one of those resources is the clay pot water filter.
And it's just a clay pot that sits inside this 5-gallon bucket with a little nozzle on it. This unit costs about $50 and can supply a family for many, many years as long as they maintain it.
Okay, so what we now established is to prevent all these illnesses, sicknesses, cholera, etc., potentially, to have that fresh water, it costs $50, right? And at the moment, we have only a few people, 30 people perhaps, with this. What we need is at least to make this village available to them, the water in every home. So we need 1,000 more.
That's right.
Right?
That's right.
I know there are many more villages, but we'll go to those when we come to them. We'll deal with one at a time.
That's right.
It's hard to imagine that people are living like this, but there also are, we know there are solutions out there. We know that there are options for them.
I want to share a story with you of some of the work that we've done. There's a small village called La Combe, and last winter, there was one family that came down with cholera. All 11 members of the family got sick. And one of the healthcare workers contacted us, and we were able to gather supplies and deliver them there to treat their water and to treat the diarrhea. They asked us then to come in and help them with sanitation because they knew that because there's no sanitation, there's no clean water. For the 110 families that are in La Combe, there has been no more cases of cholera. The education that's been done by the health workers, by helping them to learn about sanitation and how to take care of their water, we've prevented the further spread of cholera.
Even if you start out with clean water someplace and you truck it to your home in a bucket, it's gonna get contaminated. It's been shown over and over again in research to get contaminated. These buckets help solve that problem. Right. They really do. They're in the house. The kids can't reach into them and dirty the water up. You know, you've got a spigot that you open up and the water comes out. So it's a great solution.
Well, I'm hoping that if we can get young women who are sensibly able to talk about Haiti, we should take them up that road and we should then try and make a big campaign to fundraise to put the roads in to help the field workers. Mm-hmm. That is something I want to put to everybody.
That would be marvelous, wouldn't it?
I believe it's the logical answer to make life easier to get over those mountains. There's so much we could do together.
Yeah.
That's the excitement about Haiti, sharing together everything. We don't want to be just one important person. Everyone's important. And if we'll all come together, that would be amazing.
It's just marvelous to see three young people, I think with so much maturity, but also with their energy, being concerned about all these people, not just the children, but everybody, but the way that they've given of themselves, the way they've gone out to the children, that's how we've seen it this morning, and what a gift they are. They far outweighed the expectations I had. I expected good things, but they've been marvelous. They have just been marvelous.
I'm going to sing for every children in Haiti. The sing means we come from different country. We come here for the same thing, how to help the children.
情未了，像春风走来，爱无言，像雪花悄悄离去。
If you just take these three young individuals as an example of a bit of what Beauty with a Purpose can do, and then you multiply that across countries to thousands of young individuals who have the same sort of passion and commitment and desire that these guys have, the sky's the limit for these folks. It's going to be amazing.
I want to bring the message to my country and to all the world, and I want to let them know about what's happening here and why we need the help. Because we need the help, because we need to work together to help Haiti.
Merci. We saw very lovely children, very lovely and very clever. And they have no clean clothes, beautiful clothes, and no shoes.
I was given the opportunity to come here to see what Beauty with a Purpose does. And I had no idea how important it really was, because that's a hard thing to transcend to other people, because they, you know, they see a charity and they think it's a great thing, but they don't know actually what a big difference it can make.
There's so much to take in. There's so much devastation in Haiti. People are so sad. And we've got to be really positive with what we do. So we're trying to concentrate on three areas which we know will be of huge benefit. And we're going to really work now to fundraise for those, the water and the clinic and the roads. We've already started with the fundraising, and we're also going back in July with another team, and it's an honor to do it. It's a pleasure to see these people get on their feet, and that's what we should all be doing. You know, everyone that gives is a blessing, but it's a disaster not to see the money go to the right people. This is the whole point.